Sure. So my name is Terren Niethamer. I'm a third year graduate student in the biomedical sciences program here at UCSF. And I'm in the Bush lab, and we study craniofacial development. And in particular, I'm studying craniofrontonasal syndrome. Mostly work in the tissue culture room, so where we culture cells. We have these hoods that we work in where everything is sterile. So I do a lot of work there. I also do a lot of work on the microscope, on an inverted fluorescent scope and also a confocal microscope. Well, my parents are both professional musicians, so they encouraged me to do whatever I wanted to do because they did what they wanted to do, what they loved, and made a career out of it. So they have trouble understanding what I do, but they're happy that I'm happy. So. Growing up, I really loved writing, loved making up stories and being creative and writing about them. I thought I would be an English major in college. I looked into going places where I could study English. And then my junior year of high school, I took AP chemistry kind of because everyone was doing that. And I fell in love with it. The project that I'm working on, the cells that I'm working with are really needy. So I spend a lot of time in lab taking care of the cells. I have to come in every day, but that's not something that upsets me or bothers me because I love what I do. So we're looking at boundary formation between cells that express efferent V1 and cells that don't express efferent V1. Lab life is absolutely conducive to having an outside life. I think it's really important to have other things that you do, to not only be focused on work. I really like being outside. I like biking and running outside, and I play Ultimate Frisbee actually, so about once or twice a week. That's how I get out all of my angst from those failed experiments. I also still like to read and write, so that's more of a hobby for me now. And I do still play the violin, since my parents are musicians, but very recreationally, just for my own fun. I really love the feeling of discovery. And by doing research, we're working on discovering things that no one else has discovered before, that no one else knows, and we're really using that to help people. I would say that as much as it's important to find a question in research that drives you, something that you're passionate about studying, for me, mentorship has been the most important part of this journey that I've been on. Starting with that AP chemistry teacher in high school, all the way through the people who mentored me when I was just an intern in labs and when I was working as a summer student during high school and as an undergraduate student. The mentors that I had are really the people who inspired me to keep going when things went wrong at first. And so I would say that good mentorship is amazing and you should work with good people.
But the walls of the good cells look good, which is good.
Interesting. That's one thing that I really love about this lab. The people are all friendly and open and very helpful.
What do you think?
Let's see.
Everyone is available for asking questions and giving advice and just talking about science and about what experiments you're doing and how they went, what you could do to maybe improve them. I really have enjoyed that about working here. I think the idea that we're helping people with disease, we're coming into work each day and working to make the world a better place. That's really fulfilling about it too. It's nice to get up in the morning and have a purpose. And so we're hoping that if we can find a good therapeutic window in this disease, maybe we could treat pregnant women whose children have the disease and hopefully give them some kind of relief. So that's a pie in the sky goal, obviously. We won't be starting clinical trials tomorrow, but we're really trying to help people and to discover how our cells work and what happens when things go wrong, how we might be able to fix that.